The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, Text Number 6, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 12, 1973, in New Delhi, India.
Yesterday, we discussed the verse, Savai Pungshan Paro Dharma, Jato Bhakti Radhokkari. Ahoitukiya pratihata jinatma suprasidati. One gentleman was talking with me in my room, how there can be perfect peace of mind. That we discussed yesterday. Jina atma suprasidati. Prasidati means satisfied. Fully satisfied and suprasidati. Further, specifically, prasidati. How? Savai pungsang paro dharma jato bhakti radho khaje ahoituki apratihata jina atma suprasidati. This is the process. To develop our love for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, we do not know. We have got the propensity to love. Love means somebody else. Love cannot be done, or that cannot be executed only one personally, there must be another one. I love somebody, somebody loves me. So, as soon as there is question of love, there must be lover, there must be beloved, and the transaction then love. Prema, prema pumartha maha. So, we have got us loving propensity to love somebody. To love my family, first of all, love begins from family, father, mother, brother, sister. Then you extend your love to your society, to your community, then to your nation, or you can extend to the international, you can expand. But where is the end? You can expand yourself, but unless you come to the point of loving the Supreme Person, you cannot have tranquility or peace of mind. That is the secret. Just like watering the tree, you can water. Pour water on the leaves, on the branches, on the twigs, on the flowers, each and every one, very particularly. But if you forget to water on the root, then everything is spoiled. Time is spoiled. This is the Shastra's direction. Yathā taran mūlam se chanena. Tripanti taskanda bhujopa sakha. Very practical example. Just like watering, pouring water on the root of the tree, automatically you please the branches, the twigs, the leaves, the flowers, the fruits and everything. Immediately the watering energy is transformed to every part of the tree. That is practical. There is no argument. Now another example is given. Pranopaharatra jathendriyanam. You give food to the stomach and the energy will be distributed to all the parts of your body. If you want to serve separately two sweetmeats to the two eyes and two sweetmeats to ears in this way, it will be simply useless waste of time. Simply one sweetmeat If you put into the stomach and immediately feel some energy, which will be enjoyed by your eyes, by your ears, by your nose, your hands, your legs, your hair, everything. This is the process. So we have manufactured so many types of love except God. This is our defect. As soon as there is the name of God, oh, you go to Talcottara, not here. This is the position. People are so much averse, and our Shastra says that when you forget God, or when you are not religious, religious means to become devotee of God, that is religion. Very simple thing. Religion does not mean the ritualistic ceremonies. Then my religion, the ritualistic is this. In your religion, the ritualistic is this. That may be different according to time, according to the men, according to the country, climate. That may be little different. Just like we are eating. Somebody is eating somebody is eating something, somebody is eating. But the eating process and to derive the benefit by eating is the same everywhere. There is no difference. So, you may profess any religion, that doesn't matter. You may become Christian, you may become Hindu, you may become Buddhist, you may become Sikh or anyone. There are hundreds and thousands of types of religion. It doesn't matter. But the test is whether you have learned to love God. That is all. Then it is all. That is explained. Savai pungsang paro dharma, yato bhakti adhokhad. If you have learned to love God, then it doesn't matter what type of religion you are following. Then Bhagavad is very liberal. It does not say if you follow Hindu religion or if you follow this type of religion, then you will understand God. No. Any religion, it doesn't matter. But the test is whether you have advanced in loving God. But if we see that instead of loving God, you are loving something else, which is not God. Of course, God is everything. That is another thing. Without God, there cannot be anything. But still, there is the central point. It is described in the Bhagavad Gita that because everything is the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But everything is not God. That is explained. Maya tatamidam sarvam jagat abhaktam murtina. Krishna says that I am expanded in my impersonal feature everywhere. But I am not there. It is very simple to understand. Just like the sun sign is expanded all over the universe. But if you are in the sun sign, you cannot say that I am in the sun planet. No, that is not. Sun planet is 93 million miles away. But the sun sign is not different from the sun, that is also fact. But still, you cannot say, because the sun sign has entered in your room, you cannot say that I am in direct connection with the sun god or the sun planet. No. This is called achinta bhedave thilado. Simultaneously, inconceivable, one and different. So everything is God. That is a fact. And still everything is not God. That is also fact. So we have to understand this philosophy. Everything is God, without God's energy. The same thing, that the whole material world is existing on the sun sign. All scientists know it. But at the same time, the sun sign is different and non-different from the sun. Similarly, whatever we are experiencing, that is energy of God. Brahmana Shakti. These are energies of God. Sarveda Mukhilam Jagat, the whole creation, cosmic manifestation. But when there is question of love, you have to find out the origin of this energy. That is Krishna. Krishna says, Aham sarvasya prabhava, matta sarvam pravartate, iti matya bhajante mam budha bhava samannita. When one understands that everything is coming, that is the Vedanta Sutra, Janmadasya Jataha, Athata Brahma Jigyasa. Now this human form of life is meant for inquiring about the Absolute Truth. And what is that Brahma? Brahma Jigyasa. Immediate answer is Janmadasya Jataha. Brahma or the Absolute Truth is that from which or from whom everything has emanated. That answer is there, the meaning of Brahma Sutra in the Bhagavad Gita. Because we are finding out what is that Absolute Truth, where from everything is emanating, everything has come into existence. The answer is there in the Bhagavad Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhava, matta sarvam pravartati. One who knows this secret, Aham sarvasya prabhava, I am the origin of everything. Matta sarvam pravartate, everything emanates from me. Everything comes from me. Iti matya, one who has understood this fact, iti matya, bhajante mam, then he engages himself in the service of the Lord. Why? Buddha, there actually, in understanding. Buddha bhava samannita. Krishna is the origin. That is repeated in another place. Maunam janmanavanti jnanamanamang prabhadyat. Not easily to understand Krishna. In another place it is said, manusyanam sahasreshu kaschid jatati siddha jatatamapi siddhyana kaschid vetimam tatam. Out of many thousands of people, millions of people, sahasrana. Sahasrana means many thousand times of thousand. So, a man tries to become siddha. Siddha means perfect. What is that perfection? The perfection means to stop this repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. This is perfection. This is perfection. Janma mitti jarabhyadi dukkha dosane. Everyone is trying to be perfect. The whole struggle of existence is going on all over the world. How to become perfect? So that perfection ideal is different of different persons. Somebody is thinking that if I have a nice bungalow and a nice bank balance, a nice wife and children and family, then my life is perfect. Somebody is thinking that if I can make my country very happy in comparison to other country, then it is perfect. So there are different types of perfection. But actual perfection is, they do not know, that is indicated, that I am, because I have been described, I am the soul, I am not this body. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi. Within this body, there is the dehi. Dehi means the proprietor of this body. So that dehi is tatha dehantara prapti. He is changing from one body to another. One body. That's like we have got experience in this life also, from childhood to boyhood, boyhood to youthhood, as you know. As we are changing past and present, therefore after this body is annihilated. Na hannate hannamane sarire. I am not annihilated. I take another body. That body, what kind of body? That will depend on my work. Just like we become diseased, as we infect certain type of disease, we suffer from that disease. This is practical. Nature's law is there. If you infect some disease, you will have to suffer from that disease. Similarly, as we are creating our mentality by different types of activity, our next life will be according to that mentality. This is the law of nature, but we do not know. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Actually, prakriti, nature, is pulling us according to our desire, or according to our, the desire is contamination, the mental contamination, and we are creating different types of body. So our real suffering is the transmigration from one body to another. That we do not know. There is no scientist. But it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, tatha dehantara prapti. You have to accept. And that is explained in other places, in Srimad Bhagavatam. Karmana daiva netrina jantar deha upapatti. As you are creating the situation, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is also stated, janga janga vapi smarana bhavam tajattante kalevaram. At the time of your death, the situation which you have created, it will carry you, because mind is there. Mind is subtle, intelligence is subtle. That's mind, intelligence and ego, the subtle body is there. The gross body is lost, but the subtle body will take you to another gross body. It will take to the womb of another mother. And according to your karma, the mothers, by the mother's help, you will get a body and duly you will come out and begin your work. This is nature's process. It is going on. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Ahankara vimuratma karta aham iti mannate. Ahankara. But one who is puffed up with false ego, that I am this, I am that, I am big man, I am small man. But he does not know how prakriti is working. You may be very big man in this life. That does not mean that you will remain a big man in the next life. You may be bigger or you may be smaller. According karmana, what you are doing. The same example. Suppose you are Prime Minister, but if you have contaminated some disease, you must suffer. It is not that nature will excuse you, oh, you are Prime Minister, you have infected this disease and you will not suffer. No, you have to suffer. So, it is the question of creating the mind, the intelligence. Therefore, if you constantly keep yourself, your mind, absorbed in Krishna, then you get next time, next life, a body like Krishna. Which means Satchidananda Vigraha, Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha. Krishna's body is not like us, but we think that Krishna is like us. That is also condemned in the Bhagavad Gita. Abhijananti magamurha manasim tanumasi. The rascal fools, they think me as ordinary human being. All the big acharyas of our country, Shankaracharya, Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, Nimbarka, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, many big stalwarts, they have accepted Krishna through Bhagavan Sam. Are they fools that they are worshipping a human being? Are they fools? So big scholars, stalwart? No. Only the fools consider that Krishna is ordinary human being. He comes to give us lesson what is actually God. God is Krishna, Krishna's to Bhagavan Sam. Therefore, it is His mercy that it comes before us to show what is actually God. But Krishna says, abhajananti mana mura manasi. Somebody says, well, God, why God will come? He is so big, why he will come? But why he will not come? If he is so big, why you restrict him not to come? If he is very big, is it under your laws that he will not come? If he is very big, then he has the freedom to come. You cannot restrict. Therefore Krishna says, sambhavami atmaya. Under my own laws I come. Not that by your laws. Just like I will go somewhere, sometimes you are put into the prison house. Not by my personal law, by the law of the state. Similarly, this is a prison house. This whole universe, material universe, is a prison house. There is no freedom. We are thinking that we are free, but actually nobody has got freedom. A little contamination of disease, immediately your disease. Where is your freedom? If you eat a little more than you can digest, immediately there is disease. So where is your freedom? So therefore we are called conditioned soul. Prakriti kiramanani. Prakriti is taking care of. In another place Krishna says, Ishara sarvabhutanam niddeshe arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarvabhutani jantrarurani maya. The maya has given this vehicle, this body, and you are put into this. And Krishna or Ishara or the Paramatma is also within this body. So, as he wanted in your past life, Krishna has given you, through the agency of maya, a type of body, and you are moving according to your desire. This is called karmana daiva netrena. Therefore, we have to understand this subtle knowledge. But in the modern educational system, there is no such thing. Although the Bhagavad Gita is there, and it is the property of India, at least because it was spoken, the science of Bhagavad Gita. It was spoken long, long ago, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, in the sun planet. Imam vivasate yogam praktavan aham avyam vivasyan manovipraho manuikhakavibrahu. Everything is there. How important this Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness movement means we are not manufacturing anything by our fertile brain. No. We don't create anything. We simply repeat, but we try to explain for modern understanding, that's all. Otherwise there is no question of manufacturing. Because nobody can manufacture the perfect knowledge. Because we are all imperfect, our senses are imperfect. However, we may be learned, but the senses are imperfect. Therefore we cannot give perfect knowledge. Perfect knowledge can be received from higher authorities. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita say, evam parampara praptam imam rajarsayo vidu sakale neho yogarasta parantapa. As soon as the process of receiving perfect knowledge is lost, then the original purpose is lost. So, it becomes sometimes lost when the parampara system. Just like nowadays, everyone is proud of reading Bhagavad Gita. But he interprets in his own way. Everyone is at liberty to interpret Bhagavad Gita as he likes. That is the modern proposal. So there are 664 editions of Bhagavad Gita. Everyone is commenting in his own way. I have heard that there is one doctor, he has interpreted Bhagavad Gita as the talk between a patient and a physician. You see? So this is going on. Everyone whimsically, he is interpreting. Now, sometimes in our country also, we see that Mahatma Gandhi wanted to interpret Bhagavad Gita as non-violence. It is very difficult to prove, because Bhagavad Gita is spoken in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So how you can prove non-violence? So it is a difficult job. So that is not the process of understanding Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is to be understood as our Swamiji immediately talks. Then it has to be received from the parampara system. So Krishna said to Arjuna that at the present moment the parampara system is now lost. Yoga nashta parantapa, sakalena yoga nashta parantapa. It is, the parampara system has been lost, because there have been so many interpretations, wrong interpretations. Therefore, I am selecting you to make again parampara. Bhaktosi, sakhacheti. Why you are interesting me? I am not a Vedantist. I am not a sannyasi. I am not a very learned scholar. I am a military man. So why you are trying to give the instruction of Bhagavad Gita unto me? This may, question may be raised. Because Arjuna was a family man, he was not a sannyasi, neither he was a Vedantist. A military man is not expected to become a Vedantist. Kshatriya, he knows how to fight. Krishna says that I will speak to you. Why? Bhaktosi priyosi me. You are my dear friend, therefore I shall tell you. So this is the process of understanding. You have to become dear friend of Krishna. Then you will understand Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, for thousands of years, you may go on reading Bhagavad Gita. You will not learn any word of it. That is the secret. Evam parampara pratham. Imam Raja Sayabhidhi. So, our business is, we are teaching Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam as it is spoken by the authority. We don't add anything or subtract anything. Krishna says, manmana bhava mad bhakta mad jaji manga namaskar. This is the process. Manmana, you always think of me. And we say, chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. If you chant somebody's name, your friend's name, or your relative's, immediately remember the person. It is not very difficult. If you hear in the telephone somebody speaking, as soon as you hear the voice, you can understand the other side, the person is there. So, the chanting process means to always think of Krishna. 24 hours. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advises, Kirtaniya Sadahari. And what is the benefit? The benefit is, because Krishna is the supreme pure, you become purified. Just like if you remain with the fire, you become warm. Just like in the fire, you put one iron rod, it becomes warmer. At the end, the iron rod becomes red hot. And when it is red hot, it is no more iron rod, it is fire. You touch everywhere, it will burn. The same process. If you remain with Krishna always, you get Krishna's quality. You have got the quality because you are part and parcel of Krishna. If Krishna is gold, you are part and parcel of Krishna, therefore you are also gold. But at the present moment, as the gold is covered by dirt, at the present moment, we are spirit soul. We are part and parcel of Krishna, as good as Krishna, but we have been covered by this material body. Therefore, we have to take out ourselves from this material body. That is called siddhi, that is called perfection. So, manusyanam sahasyeshu kaschid jagati siddhaya. Nobody knows how to become perfect. They are struggling very hard to become perfect. Individually, socially, nationally. But how they can be perfect? They do not know what is perfection. This is perfection. Takta deham punarjanma nayati. If you do not take another material and do not accept another material body, this is the final. That is perfection. That is the injunction of the Shastra. Namo chayadda samupeta mrittam, guru na sashyat, pita na sashyat, janani na sashyat. These are the injunction of the Shastra. Don't try to become a guru, or don't try to accept a so-called guru. Who cannot save you from this repetition of birth and death. This is injunction. Not that guru has given me some mantra, I am now poor man, I become very rich man. No, that is not. Real purpose of life, how to get out of this repetition of birth and death. That is wanted. So that is very simple method. If you become Krishna conscious, if you develop Krishna consciousness, you understand. By Krishna consciousness means you understand what is Krishna. Otherwise, if we superficially try to understand Krishna, we understand Krishna is an ordinary human being. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukadeva Goswami is remarking, when Krishna is playing with the cowherd's voice, he is describing, ittham brahma sukhanu, ittham satana brahma sukhanu bhutya, dasam gatanam pradaivatenam, maya sitanam naradaivatenam, naradarakenam sadhang vijarhu kritapunna punya. These boys who are playing with Krishna, they are ordinary cowherd boys. Krita punna punya. Krita punna punya means they acquire volumes of the result of pious activities. Now they have been allowed to play with Krishna. And who is this Krishna? Ittham satanga brahma sukhanu bhutya. This boy, Krishna, he is the target of the brahma su. Brahma sukhanu bhutya. He is the worshipable lord of the devotees, dasam gatanam paradaivatena, and mayasitanam naradarakena. Those who are mayasita, within the clutches of maya, they are thinking he is an ordinary boy. But he is not an ordinary boy. So, by Krishna consciousness, by constantly thinking of Krishna, as Krishna advises, manmana bhava madbhakta madhyaji maganamasu. If you dovetail your whole life to these principles, thinking of Krishna, manmana, to become devotee of Krishna, madhbhakta, madhyaji, to worship Krishna, and to simply, if you cannot do anything, either four or one if you can do, if you simply come and offer your obeisances to Krishna, you are getting the benefit. Krishna says, manmana bhava madhbhakta madhyaji maga namaskuru. Ne navada bhakti sevanam kirtanam vishnu sravanam pada sevanam. In this way, if you remain attached with Krishna, that is the perfection.